Hi, I'm Paxton, a material scientist at Formlabs. In this video, we will do a deep dive into how to produce short-run injection molds in a matter of hours using 3D printing. Traditional injection molds often take weeks and thousands of dollars to manufacture. But with Formlabs stereolithography 3D printers, you can fabricate low-volume injection molds in-house at a fraction of the cost and time. You can use 3D printed molds with both industrial and benchtop injection molding machines to produce dozens to hundreds of molded parts. This is a powerful way to iterate and accelerate product development at every stage: prototypes, pre-production parts, or limited series runs. In this tutorial, we will guide you through the complete workflow for injection molding parts using 3D printed molds produced with the Formlabs SLA ecosystem. We will provide design guidelines, recommend what 3D printing material to choose, walk you through best practices for printing, post-processing, machining, and assembling your mold before injection, and share tips for molding parts on an industrial injection molding machine. For this specific application, we are using stereolithography SLA 3D printing technology. SLA is an excellent choice for mold fabrication because it produces precise parts with a smooth surface finish. Surface finish is very important in this application. Rough or irregular mold surfaces can increase the injection pressures required, as well as make demolding more difficult. Furthermore, unlike some other print technologies, SLA printing results in chemical bonds between layers. This means that parts are more dense and material properties are more isotropic. Formlabs offers a range of desktop and large format SLA printers, which are easy to operate and maintain. In this video, I will work with the Form 4 printer and its complete ecosystem, which includes preform software, resin, and post-processing equipment like the Form Wash and Form Cure. To get started printing, the first question is what material to choose. Formlabs has an extensive materials library for many applications. Because injection molding involves high heat and pressure, we recommend 3D printing molds with rigid 10K resin. Rigid 10K resin is a highly glass-filled material with extreme stiffness, comparable to ceramics and glass-filled thermoplastics. It is also highly resistant to chemicals and has a heat deflection temperature of over 230 degrees Celsius. This means that rigid 10K parts will maintain their shape at relatively high pressures and temperatures. Now that you know which 3D printing material to work with, you are ready to build your mold. If you are new to the Formlabs ecosystem, you can read our support articles linked in the description to get started with our 3D printers, software, and post-processing equipment. Throughout this video, I will use these parts: a two-piece injection mold for a threaded nut, as well as a set of ejector pins. The first step is to design your mold in your preferred CAD software. We won't cover design guidelines in this video, but we have tutorials available on our channel to guide you through the design steps. Look in the video description for links. Once your model is ready, export the STL file and upload it into Preform, Formlabs' print preparation software. Now you will prepare your print before sending it to the 3D printer. Proper print preparation is critical, both for ensuring print success and improving the performance of the mold. In Preform, you can select print settings, orient your part, and add supports. You'll need to select your printer, rigid 10K resin, and the layer thickness. Smaller layer heights typically result in greater dimensional accuracy and a finer surface finish. A more smooth surface finish may help reduce adhesion from the injected material to the mold, so we recommend printing with a layer height of 50 microns. Next, strategically orient your mold. Minimizing the amount of flat area in the XY plane will help reduce warping and curling of thin segments or large flat surfaces. So for these features, we recommend that the mold be tilted. For thicker and blockier models, this is less of a concern, especially in rigid 10K. But here, we show you an example of how you would angle your part. Angling your mold can also help minimize the amount of supports needed on critical mold surfaces. Support generation is essential for overhangs and for lifting the part off the build platform to prevent cupping. Ensure you support any free hanging cores, especially small diameter ones, but avoid placing supports on molding surfaces. Increasing support density will also help to minimize warping. Send the print job to the printer and start your print. After your print finishes, there are three main steps required for post-processing stereolithography parts: rinsing in a wash solvent like IPA, removing supports, and post-curing. Thoroughly wash your parts in IPA with a form wash to remove all uncured resin. Because rigid 10K resin contains glass particles, we advise maintaining a wash bucket separate from other resins. Run a first wash cycle of 10 minutes to remove the bulk of resin. Then transfer your parts and perform another 10-minute wash cycle and a second form wash with clean solvent. If your mold has internal channels, ensure liquid resin is thoroughly flushed out from these features. You can use a syringe or wash bottle filled with IPA, followed by compressed air. During the wash, a small amount of IPA will soak into and swell your parts. For best results, make sure your parts are fully dried before post-curing, or the entrained IPA may cause stains or cracks at the surface. At room temperature, drying will take 3 to 4 hours, but this process can be sped by heating your part in the second generation form cure. After your parts are washed and dried, you can then remove the supports and sand off the support marks with sandpaper if needed. Your parts are now ready for post-curing, but if you need to do any machining of your parts, we recommend that you do that now. Machining can be performed to refine critical features such as gating, vents, and ejector pinholes, or facing the top and bottom of your mold to ensure a good fit. Rigid 10K resin can be machined using standard CNC or manual milling equipment. Machining can also be performed after post-curing. However, it is more likely to cause chipping and cracking, especially for tapping and drilling operations. You are now ready to post-cure your parts. Post-curing ensures 3D printed parts reach their optimal mechanical properties. We recommend first UV curing your rigid 10K mold for 7 minutes at 80 degrees Celsius, and then additionally thermally curing your mold in an oven for 125 minutes at 90 degrees Celsius. You can help minimize warpage during post-cure by placing your mold inside the form cure before it starts heating, so that it reaches a more even temperature during UV curing. You can also clamp your mold during curing to mitigate warping, especially for large molds. For parts printed in rigid 10K, we also recommend media blasting to further improve mechanical properties. This is an optional step, but after extensive research and testing, we've discovered that media blasting rigid 10K increases material strength across every metric. Media blasting may also improve mold performance in several ways. Smoothing the mold surface will reduce defects that could cause part failures and may help to decrease required injection pressures. It will also improve surface finish and reduce the adhesion of the injected material to the mold. The process of media blasting changes the surface color of rigid 10K parts from white to cream, but if done carefully, will not significantly affect part dimensions. Pay attention to the surface color as you blast to know when you have removed enough material. Test specimens in this video were media blasted with 70 to 140 mesh glass beads on all surfaces at an air pressure of 90 PSI. You can use the fuse blast or any other standard media blasting cabinet. A final rinse or wipe with IPA to remove any remaining particulate might be beneficial, followed by thorough drying, especially if you plan on applying any coatings afterwards. After machining, post-curing, and media blasting, we recommend installing your mold inside a metal frame. This frame helps to absorb some of the pressure and temperature during the injection molding process, which could significantly extend the mold's lifespan. Without media blasting, the surfaces of parts printed in rigid 10K resin may feel powdery. Rubbing mineral oil or water into your part surface and wiping away any excess will lead to a smoother, less powdery finish. When your mold is assembled, you can apply a standard mold release spray to improve demolding, especially if you're injecting viscous material like TPU. More advanced coating methods are available for those seeking to push the performance of their 3D printed molds even further. Ceramic coatings such as Cerakote, for example, offer exceptional hardness, chemical resistance, and high temperature resilience. Various polymer coatings, such as epoxies or polyurethane, can improve surface smoothness and provide a protective layer against abrasion or chemical interaction with the injected material. Lastly, electroplating may provide a true metallic surface that dramatically boosts durability and conductivity. While these options have not undergone exhaustive testing by Formlabs, we encourage users to explore these options to find the one best suited to their needs. For some starting points and more information, please see the details below this video. Before wrapping up, I'd like to show a few examples of molds that our customers have used. This mold was made by the company Novus Applications to produce hundreds of units in HDPE for prototyping a threaded cap. This mold was made by the company Multiplus to produce hundreds of units in polypropylene, ABS, and polycarbonate for prototyping an electronic housing. This mold was made by the company IPC to produce thousands of units in polypropylene. You can find more details on user stories, molding conditions, and more in the description below. Rigid 10K resin generally yields the best results for this application, though success depends on part geometry, injected material, and molding parameters. Alternatively, high temp resin can work for thin walls, but is more brittle, while standard resins offer a cost-effective solution for small parts and low cycles. And that wraps up our deep dive into producing short-run injection molds with Formlabs SLA 3D printers and rigid 10K resin. By leveraging 3D printed molds, you can significantly reduce the lead time and cost associated with traditional metal tooling, bringing efficient, low-volume injection molding in-house. This hybrid manufacturing approach allows you to quickly iterate on designs and produce functional prototypes or limited series parts in a fraction of the time, typically within days rather than weeks. If you have any further questions or want to explore specific applications, don't hesitate to reach out to our solutions specialists. Thanks for watching.